It's Thursday, February 28th. I'm Wayne Moore. This is Evening Update. At the top of the news, a conservative MP for Central Okanagan, Samilk Amin, has joined the list of those demanding Prime Minister Justin Trudeau resign. Dan Albus made the assertion Thursday, a day after former Attorney General Jody Wilson-Raybould spoke before the Justice Committee on the SNC-Lavalin affair. Albus says it's clear there was inappropriate and potentially illegal pressure brought on her by the highest officials in Justin Trudeau's government, all in a bid to let a Liberal-connected corporation off the hook on corruption charges. Police officers descended on a Lake Country residential street on Thursday afternoon. Residents near Pretty Road posted on social media saying they were told to stay indoors and keep their doors locked. Corporal Megan Foster tells Castanet that police responded for a report of an assault. Snow may have played a factor in a couple of serious-looking crashes in the Okanagan Thursday morning. About 10 a.m., a vehicle hit a tree after leaving Highway 33 near Philpott Road. The vehicle eventually came to rest in a ditch. On Highway 97, emergency crews were called to an accident on that highway near Clerk Road after a vehicle went into a ditch there as well. RCMP warned drivers to be cautious and drive according to conditions. No word on injuries in either incident. An incident caught on camera at a beer hockey league game in West Kelowna has gone viral. Videos show an altercation in the third period of a Pacific Adult Hockey League game between the Flamingos and the Rumblebees. Eric Dion, a player with the Rumblebees, says he got checked into the opposing goaltender, and after some chirping between the two sides, the goalie snapped his stick. The incident has been picked up by major networks across the country, including TSN Barstool Sports and Jay and Dan. The South Okanagan Events Center is sailing into choppy waters in 2019, with the complex's forecasted operating shortfall ballooning to $1.46 million. That driven by a lack of marquee events this year, an increased minimum wage, and new local competition. SOEC General Manager Dean Clark told Council during its final day of budget deliberations their bottom line is taking a hit due to the lack of any major multi-day events this year. That could change for the SOEC in 2021. The Penticton V's have put in a bid to host the 2021 RBC Cup, the National Junior A Hockey Championship. Dean Clark says the bid is part of SOEC's renewed focus on hosting large multi-day marquee events in an attempt to reduce that operating loss at the complex. Nine other cities are also putting in a bid. Trueleaf Medicine International Limited had its best sales quarter ever for the three-month period ending December 31st of last year. Revenues were generated from global sales of the company's legal hemp-based products for pets. Sales of the products totaled $653,000 and change, making it the company's third record-setting quarter in a row. It's been a month since a cowboy disappeared from Merritt, and now investigators are turning to you for video footage. Officers from the Southeast District Major Crime Unit are seeking dash camera or video or other video footage to help find 32-year-old Ben Tyner. Tyner's saddled horse was discovered on January 28th on a logging road off Highway 97 near Winnie Flats, 2 days after he was last seen. Just days after police removed propane tanks and other fire hazards from a homeless camp in Maple Ridge, video has been posted of an explosive fire at the site. The video was posted to YouTube on Wednesday by Jerry Gray and shows a loud explosion as thick black smoke and flames rise from the camp. It's not known what caused the fire or if anyone was injured. Okanagan weather: periods of snow should end sometime late Thursday evening. Lows overnight to -5. Mix of sun and cloud Friday. Highs to +1. Coming up tonight and tomorrow, vandalism in downtown Kelowna could be part of a larger issue. And HomeSense is expanding to Penticton. For details on these and the rest of the day's news, keep it here at castanet.net. For Castanet News, I'm Wayne Moore.